Cleveland baseball. The Tribe.
Yes!
Baboon here for Papa Bassin. Baboon here. Baboon here. Do I even have to tell you? Baboon here for Puff Puff Bass. Old baboon here for Puff Puff Bass fishing. Another day, another trip to the farm pond. It is a beautiful, I would say fall day. And I am headed out to the farm pond. I got some heavy equipment in front of me right now. Stay tuned, Puff Puff Bass. Alright, baboon here. So here's what I'm using with the catfish tonight. Teardrop hook, I believe, something like that, with a few holes in it. It's made by a company, I think it's the same company that makes this little stinker. So this is a tube of chicken liver catfish bait, and you fill this little teardrop shaped rubber piece, you can see the holes in there, you fill it up with that and it'll hold that inside of there. I also have some magic bait, catfish bait. This is the grasshopper and chicken blood. Using my Lewes bait casting reel, it's a medium heavy action rod. That's the only reason I'm using this instead of the other one. Alright, baboon here. I got my first largemouth of the night. This is a nice bass. Alright, 1.33. This is a nice bass. I weighed him. He weighs 1.33 pounds. Time to get him back in the water. Hi, baby. How are you? Did you see that fish? What do you think? This gets him out here. It's got a really nice lifelike presentation. It really swims in the water. It's hard for them to resist it. Four rod offset hook. This is a 4.5 inch swimmer. That's what they call it. Smallie Magic. I think that's what they call that color. Of course, I have my own bait right here. Bush. It's my bait. I am pumped. Take a look at this chunk. That right there is the biggest bass I've ever caught out of this little pond. There's a view of him. It's a nice bass. All right, he's weighing in at 2.31 pounds. It's a nice fish though. You good, bud? He's good. Excited. Baboon here for Puff Puff Bass. Got my third largemouth. This one almost seems like the same one, but I would think it's different. Very rarely have I ever caught the same largemouth twice. I'm gonna weigh him just to make sure. Nice bass. Having a good night out here. I just lost a catfish, so that's disappointing, but still got a little bit of time to try. So, baboon with the third largemouth of the night. Stay tuned. There he is, nice 2-pounder there. Out of the farm pond, third one of the night. Let's get a release on this guy. Anywhere from, oh, I have all kinds of shit. I need to go through this and clean it up a little bit. I don't know what to go with next. That might do something. Or just go with the Senko, you know? There's just shit everywhere. Maybe. Look at this shit. It's just full of all of my... Those are nice. All of my soft plastics. Cleveland baseball. The Tribe. American League Central champions. Alright, baboon out here. What'd I tell you? Gary Greentip. Never does me wrong. Well, Puff Puff Bass Nation, I am very excited right now. because a yellow perch. That right there is a nice size yellow perch. Normally we catch these in Lake Erie, but the owner of this pond bought some yellow perch fry back when they dug this pond out, made it a little deeper, a little bigger. She put them in here, and now this is the result. Nice size yellow perch. There he is. That's a nice size yellow perch, especially for a little pond like this. So, seeing as though we most of the time catch these out of Lake Erie, that's what I'm gonna name this guy as Erie. Whoop. Well, there he goes. All right, just released that yellow perch. That was a nice size perch. Second one I've caught out of here. First one was on a Senko, and cast it a couple more times, and I got a nice size largemouth. He's not too big. He's got a little fat, chunky belly on him. Let's get him back in here. Ready to go. Just came off of this little spinner. Little red eye. I call these like a bleeding spinner bait. As the sun sets over there over the corn, and see if I can't maybe get one or two more. We'll see. Can't even see, it's pretty steep over here. I like to typically try to release them a little bit better than that. But this property owner has rocks all around the edge of this pond. These little, like, I don't even know what you call these things. Little, like, river rocks, I guess. And this particular side right here is really steep, so you slide all the way down into the pond if you're not careful. So I'm gonna get out of here. Baboon signing off.